Hi, and welcome to another one of the performance reviews by the Tech Geeks. My name's Paul. We recently released a video on the performance we could get running intrusion prevention on a UDM Pro, a UDM SE, and a UDM Pro Max. And it was really good. We could get maybe 5 to 6 gigabits a second, and that was doing networking. And I thought that was a pretty good indication of what we could get from the device. We're only testing its 10 gig capacity really, but that was sort of a good idea. As soon as we posted that video, I started getting people going, well, that's not the performance I get, or what is the performance we get when actually the device is under load, i.e., you know, the RAM is being, you know, is pretty heavily used and the CPU is pretty heavily used. And that's a fair point. So how do we replicate that or duplicate that? This is my sort of setup as a go and see whether we can do this. It's a little bit more rough and ready because I had to try and get some bits and pieces together to make this work. So what are we doing? We're doing the same set of tests with a UDM Pro, a UDM SE, and a UDM Pro Max. What have we done? We're going to load 8 cameras to it. That's the recommended, or 8 4K cameras. That's the recommended limit for the UDM Pro and the UDM SE. The Pro Max can potentially do about 15. So we should see a performance improvement in that model. So what have we just done? Have we just connected the cameras? No, we've not just connected the cameras. They need to be doing something. They need to be generating definitions for you know, recording that's happened. So what have we got? So let me just show you a little bit of what we got here. So the way we've done this is, so obviously for the UDM Pro and the UDM Pro Max, they don't have a PoE switch. So just the way down in here, we've got a USW Flex 8 PoE. All right, we've got its 210 watt power pack down there. And then that is gonna power all of these and then be plugged into the UDM Pro and the UDM Pro Max. When we do the UDM SE, then we're gonna plug all of these cameras directly into the UDM SE. So that will probably have a little bit more loading because it's doing the PoE and the networking. What have we then got? We've got then 2 Onviv cameras. All right, so these happen to be Reolink ones. They're 4K cameras. So they're gonna be doing continuous recording. We have then got 5 G6 turrets and 1 G6 bullet. Now, just putting those in is not really gonna be enough. So what we've got up at this level here, we've actually got a laptop running that's running a continuous loop of a whole load of different YouTube videos. So these cameras are pointing to it. What do we want to see? We want to see person and vehicle detections. So these are actually generating footage. These are actually all going to be set to continuous record anyway. So we've got a full stream of data coming back to the UDM Pros and we've got definitions actually happening as well. Now, just caveat all of this a little bit for you. I'm not using PPPoE. So if your internet service provider uses PPPoE, then you will definitely get a performance decrease. If you're just being able to plug your Ethernet in and you're not having to send a username and password, then that's what is happening here. I will show you on the UDM SE and the Pro Max, its speed on its 2.5 gigabit a second port. There is some comments that maybe if you're just using the 2.5 gigabit a second port that you won't get as good a performance. I haven't seen that, but again, this is cameras and loading. This is not doing lots of VLANs and everything else like that. If you've already got VLANs and inter VLAN firewall rules, that will hit the performance a little bit more. I'm mainly concentrating on us using the 10 gig. So I've got a 10 gig DAC cable, this one here. So I've got one of these running for the WAN. And then let me just see if I can unplug this quickly over here. On the LAN side, I've got an SFP plus converter plugged in. This is a multi-gig transceiver. This one here, here we go. So this is, can take us for 1 gig, 2.5, 5, and 10. And so if you really want to get that faster speed, I would probably recommend you use this on the LAN as well. So those are probably sort of my caveats. You'll then see that the loading will come pretty high there. And I'll show you the CPU on the computer. You'll see our memory sits pretty high as well. So with all of that running, then we're going to run our set of speed tests, and hopefully that'll give you an idea of the performance review that we can get across all of this with a good amount of loading on it. So let's jump onto the computer and see what we can get.
Okay, so just hopped on over to the computer now. This is the UDM Pro. Obviously, UDM Pro doesn't have PoE ports, so I've put this on a Flex 2.58. Obviously, when we do the UDM SE, then there probably will be a little bit more load because it's going to be running all of the, both the PoE power and also all the networking for all of those. With this UDM Pro, I'm not going to test this at 1 gig speed, which is its WAN connected. I'm going to try and see what we can do on the 10 gig, because obviously if we get over 1 gig, then we know on the 1 gig we would get 1 gig anyway, if that makes sense. So all the cameras are adopted in here. I've got a video playing in the background, so actually, in fact, it's already doing AI detections on people and faces and stuff that I actually see. So we're actually generating some load in here. These are all 4K cameras, like I mentioned before. So they're all actually in there and running. So we can see that some of the load is a little bit high anyway, while it's trying to actually get those happening. What we'll do is we'll actually let this run as a live stream that's happening there as well. So there we can see, we've got a load of 14, memory at 84. So let me just hop on over to my virtual machine and we can actually see what we can get with this load. IPS and everything is turned on. So let's just do a test here. I'm gonna run it with 10 streams, just see what we're gonna get. So we're getting we're getting 6 gig. So a little bit slower than my other video that we did when it was under load. But still fairly significant. Let's just really saturate this connection up to 100. Let's just see what we can push this down to. So even when we're really maxing out our 10 gig connection, then you can still see getting about 4.97 gigabits a second. So still a good solid result. So let's head on over to the UDM Pro SE and see the results that we get on that. All right, so let's repeat the test here on the UDM SE, 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port. We can see that the video is still playing. We can still see that we are logging events in here. So we've still got some active stuff running. Our CPU, our memory is at just under 80%. Our CPU is actually running quite easily at the moment. So let's just clear the results on here. All right, and let's just saturate this. Just let's run with 10 streams at the moment. We can see that's quite comfortably again, sitting at 2.3, 2.37 gigabits a second on that 2.5 gigabit a second port. So let's now just quickly swap that over onto the 10 gig and run the test again. Okay, so you can see switched over to the 10 gig port. You can see our load is a lot higher at this moment in time. Memory is somewhat up. So we'll just try with those 10 streams, the 10 streams that we did before. Let's just clear this. So the 10 streams, I just did a couple of tests before this. So that's the 10 streams on here. And we can see 5.9 to 6 point. Remember, we were getting slightly higher when we had this just as a router in the previous video that we've done. Now what we'll do is we're just gonna push this up, just try and see if we can saturate the connection completely. So let's put this up to 100 streams and let's just see what we can bring this down to. So again, still in the 4.7. So we're still seeing a really, really good performance. Let's just quickly spin back, have a look and see what our load is at. Our load is at 24, just under 90% of memory usage. So again, a pretty solid result there on the UDM SE. So let's repeat the test on the next one. Okay, so just moved everything over to the UDM Pro Max. Now the key thing with the Pro Max here is that it actually supports twice as many cameras. So I'm not really going to expect much difference to this overall. So we will quickly test this, see that this is all still running comfortably. If we check in, find anything, we've already got detections happening. If we have a look at our load, we can see that's a little bit lower and definitely our CPU is a lot lower. So let's just quickly head on over here. Let's just quickly run this now with 10 streams. This is on a 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port. Again, no difference really from what we've seen before. So 2.3 gigabits a second. Quite happy with that. So let's now just quickly switch that over to the 10 gig interface and just try that test one more time. Okay, so the 10 gig is plugged in. As you can see up here, you can see our CPU has jumped, our memory's jumped a little bit. Our CPU is about the same. Our cameras are still streaming and running. We've still got a whole load of detections actually happening in there. So let's pop that back into this place. Let's jump over to here. Let's do our speed test again. And just see what we're gonna get. So 4.2, 5.3, 5.3 gigabits a second. So again, really solid response that we can see on this. Now remember, this should be able to do twice as many as the other devices. Let's push this up to 100 streams. Let's just see. So we had seen on the UDM Pro, the original one that we dropped down into that threes, seems to hold it at about 5 gig a second. So we can see with eight 4K cameras, running with all the detections running and overloading the connection, we can still get just under 5 gigabits or just on the 5 gigabits a second with the UDM Pro-Max. And just a reminder there, this one with its load there only running about 5 and memory of about 46%.
All right, so hopefully that was useful. What you can see, there are ways of completely maxing this out. Now, like I said, there are other ways that you might have issues with this. If you've got VLANs, you've got specific firewall rules and stuff like that. But as you can see, even with really, really heavy loading, 100 streams and all the cameras running, then we still were probably only pushing that down to about 3.3 gigabits a second. So still a really good performing unit. But you can see then again, with that more standard set of streams, that you know you are still seeing at the 5, you know, to 5 gigs, sometimes up to that 6 as well. So hopefully that's been useful. That's how we've tried to show you what we can do. Obviously your environment might be slightly different, but hopefully gives you an idea with 8 4K cameras, 2 being on Viv, all continuously recording, all doing definition recording. So we're trying to do some of that AI stuff as well, that we can get a performance that's pretty good out of the UDM Pro, the UDM SE, and the UDM Pro Max. Why don't you head on over to our YouTube channel? We've got plenty more performance reviews, how to set up guides, how to set up Unifi Protect, for instance, and get it setting up like this as well. So why don't you head on over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.